And welcome back to my channel. My name is Emily and I talk a lot about Salesforce. Today we're going to be going over roles and role hierarchies within Salesforce. Now I have done this video before, significantly upgraded my setup since then, so it should be a little easier to listen and watch, and also adding some new information. So let's go ahead and jump into the setup, and we're going to go to roles and role hierarchies within the setup, within the quick find. Actually, let's do roles. All right, so let's take a minute to talk about security within Salesforce first. So there are two-ish types of security within Salesforce that are going to be the biggest security talking points. That is object-level security, and that is going to be record-level security. So I like to use the example of a library, specifically the library at Hogwarts within Harry Potter. So if you're thinking about object level security, that is going to be very similar to a library. It is going to open up access to the different sections of the library. So you may have different sections such as potions at the Harry Potter library, and you have sections that maybe require a little bit more care, like the restricted section. So the different things in the object level security are going to first establish a baseline security for everyone. Everyone has access to this and this and this. And then with the different tools such as profiles and permission sets, you can open up access to the different sections of the library. So how this would work in Salesforce is everyone would have access to maybe leads and opportunities and accounts, and then based upon your different needs, that they will open up other objects such as the cases object or knowledge, or opening up marketing and campaigns, those types of things. And opening up that specific pieces and maybe edit access as well would be done through permission sets and profiles. So that's a little overview of object level security. Now we're going to be going into record level security. So record level security, if we're going back to this Harry Potter example, is going to be anything, or is going to be once you have access to the sections, is do you have access to these specific books that are in there? So you may not be able to check out certain books that you are not mentioned in, or you may not be able to check out specific books that you're not like enrolled in that class for. And so how this would work in Salesforce is if you are not on an opportunity, you may not be able to see it. If you're not on a lead or listed as the lead owner, or one of your subordinates is not a lead owner, then you may not see the record. So that is how a little high-level overview of object-level versus record-level security. I hope that made sense. If you have any questions, drop them down below. So let's jump into roles and role hierarchies. So this is going to follow your company's hierarchy, I guess, and it will determine the sharing of different records. So there are a few different examples here. You can do territory, product, and company size. I like to do territory. This one's best indicative. So at the very top of this hierarchy, we have the CEO, and maybe we have the CFO, the C-suite, anyone who is high level. And then below them, you'll have the different sales directors in each market. So you have Western sales, you have Eastern sales directors, and international sales directors. And then beneath each of these sales directors, you have Western sales, Eastern sales, and international sales reps. So each person in the role hierarchy, typically, if the records are enabled to be seen with the role hierarchy, can see the records of people who are subordinate to them within the role hierarchy. So Western sales district or Western sales director can see any of the Western sales reps records. Eastern sales can see any of the sales reps records. Same with international. International director can see sales reps. And even if they have like five different reps underneath them, they can see all five of those different reps records. One thing about the role hierarchy is typically you cannot see from a diagonal way. So the Western sales director typically cannot see the Eastern sales reps' records. They can only see the reps that they are directly over. And so the higher up in the hierarchy you get, the more records you can see, edit, and all those things. Now there are different ways to get around this. There's manually sharing. There are sharing rules that you can get around with this. But this is just kind of the baseline for roles. So let's go ahead and show you a little bit more as to what these roles are. And very similarly to how profiles are for the object level security, you will need to assign roles to each person. So we have the CEO at Call Solutions. We have the CFO, COO, the senior VP, all those people. I'm going to go down to the senior VP of marketing. And now you can see we have international sales. And we can add more roles because there's no one underneath international sales. So from here, if we add new role, we can enter in a label for the role. So let's have this be international sales rep. And they will report to the VP of international sales. Now we could have this also be director, but it should typically match the role hierarchy of the company. And this will depend highly on the different company size as well. So now we have the international sales rep, and what we would be able to do here is we can go ahead and add in people to, or assign users to this role. I'm going to go back to the roles. So now that we've set up a role for this example, I want to show you other examples that we could use for this. There are product-based roles. So in this example, we have the VP of hardware, the VP of software, and networking. And then we have different reps underneath them. So this is another great example. Or we could do it based upon company size, where you have the different markets of selling. So you have SoHo, mid-market, and Fortune 1000. Each of these different ways is a way to set it up. Now, if you are not necessarily a sales-heavy company, maybe you are a contractor or, yeah, just not super heavy, you can do this for service as well. You could do this for marketing. You can do this for like a products-based business or a service-based business. Let's say you are a plumbing company and you have different field service agents. You could have a field service agent with maybe a dispatcher that is over them and a manager who's also over them to all of your plumbers that you are sending out into the field. You would be able to do this using the role hierarchy as well. That is a very high-level basic overview of roles, how they fit into the security model of Salesforce, and the role hierarchy. I know this was kind of complex. A few other things is that you can edit and delete the different roles. So if this does not work for you, you can totally change it around. And one little wrench that does get thrown into here a lot is the system admins on the platform. And so you might want to account for that as well. If maybe there are system admin permissions that you want to add. So just be cognizant of that. And yeah, high level. Hope that you found this helpful. If you have any questions, be sure to drop them down below in the comments and I'll try to get back to you as soon as possible. Be sure to check out the courses down below. Like, subscribe, you can join the email list at salesforceemily.com, and I will catch you guys in the next one.